Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 9th of April. 7 terrorists neutralized in separate encounters in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Pakistanis gear up for Ramadan amid rising inflation and COVID-19 infections. And Afghan Interior Ministry releases confessions of 9 suspects in targeted attacks. And now for all the details. At least 7 terrorists were neutralized by security forces in 2 separate encounters in India's Jammu and Kashmir on Friday. A senior police official said the chief of Ansar Ghazwatul Hind was also among the slain terrorists.
Security forces on Friday neutralized 7 terrorists in 2 separate encounters in Shopian and Pulwama districts of India's Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir in the past 24 hours. The encounter at Shopian started on Thursday evening and ended on Friday with the killing of 5 terrorists, while 2 terrorists, including the chief of Ansar Ghazwatul Hind, Imtiaz Shah, were killed in a separate operation at Thral in Pulwama district on Friday. A senior police official said the terrorists gunned down in Shopian belong to Pakistan-based Hizbul Mujahideen and Lashkar-e-Taiba terror outfits.
साथ के साथ तो टेररिस के हाथ में AK-47 था, 2 पिस्टल एक्स्ट्रा था. इनके खिलाफ काफी केस दर्ज है. ये सिविलियन किलिंग इन्वॉल्व था. उसमें से इम्तियाज है एक जो था, जो सोकॉल्ड अपने आप को एजेस का चीफ मानता था.
India has long blamed Pakistan of arming and infiltrating terrorists from across the border to spread unrest in Kashmir Valley. Pakistan, however, denies the charges.
India reported another record number of new COVID-19 infections on Friday, with daily deaths also hitting their highest in more than 5 months as the country battles a second wave of infections and states complain of a persistent vaccine shortage. The world's second most populous country reported 131,968 new infections and 780 deaths on Friday, the biggest daily increase since mid-October.
India reported another record number of new COVID-19 infections on Friday, with daily deaths also hitting their highest in more than 5 months as the country battles a second wave of infections. The world's second most populous country reported 131,968 new infections and 780 deaths on Friday, the biggest daily increase since mid-October. Meanwhile, several vaccination centers around the country, including in worst-hit Maharashtra state, have been temporarily shut as they reportedly ran out of doses to inoculate people against the deadly virus. Inoculations are currently limited to those aged over 45 and health and frontline workers in India.
पहले डोज मैंने यही लिया और सेकंड डोज के लिए आया था, पर ये वैक्सीन अवेलेबल नहीं है, कब आएगा ये भी मालूम नहीं है, बड़ी तकलीफ हो रही है. इसके कारण पेशेंट बढ़ते जा रहे हैं, क्या हो रहा है कुछ समझ में नहीं आ रहा है. स्टेट गवर्नमेंट कुछ बोलती है, सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट कुछ बोलती है, इसमें कॉमन आदमी को बहुत बड़ी तकलीफ हो रही है.
With several states having expanded curbs to control the rapid spread of the virus, migrant workers have also started packing into trains towards their villages from major cities such as Mumbai, potentially risking a wider outbreak in smaller towns. Governments are willing to impose lockdowns fearing economic slump and losses of employment, but have imposed night curfews to deal with the situation.
In news from Pakistan, outrage has continued after Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan blamed how women dress for a rise in rape cases in the country. Pakistani women activists and rights campaigners have accused Khan of baffling ignorance and demanded apology.
Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan is facing a backlash from rights groups as well as his two ex-wives for remarks over the weekend linking the country's high incidence of rape to obscenity in society. Khan, during a live television program on April 5, said that when you increase obscenity in society, of course there will be an effect. What is the whole concept of the veil in our Islamic religion? That there is no temptation in society. Khan's office said on Wednesday his remarks had been taken out of context. Demonstrations by rights activists have demanded that PM Khan should apologize, as his remarks not only displayed a baffling ignorance of where, why and how rape occurs, but it also lays the blame on rape survivors.
The Prime Minister has no understanding that there is nothing to do, you know, with Parda. And it's not that the women who are in Parda are not getting raped. Women are getting raped even while they are within their homes, you know. So making such a chauvinistic, such a sexist, such an insensitive statement, I think it has outraged all of us.
Khan's first wife, British socialite Jemima Khan, said on Twitter, "The onus is on men." Quoting a passage from the Quran, calling on men to avert their gaze from women. His second wife, Reham Khan, also said in a tweet that Khan had a totally wrong way of thinking about rape. In March, a court in Lahore sentenced two men to death for gang raping a woman travelling along a major highway last year. The incident sparked nationwide protest after one senior police official publicly questioned why the woman had been driving alone at night with her children.
More on news from Pakistan. Preparations for the Islamic holy month of Ramadan in Pakistan's Islamabad are muted this year amid concerns about the coronavirus and rising inflation. Ramadan, which depends on the sighting of the moon, is expected to begin in Pakistan from April 14.
Preparations for the holy month of Ramadan in Pakistan's capital of Islamabad are muted this year amid concerns about the coronavirus and rising inflation. While people would typically be stocking up on provisions and preparing to entertain family and friends for the breaking of the dawn to sunset fast, this year markets appear empty, and some shopkeepers say they are fighting a losing battle. The annual rate of inflation rose to 9.05% in March, up from 8.7% the previous month.
Mehngai bahut zyada hai. तो गुजारा नहीं हो रहा लोगों का अभी ये रमज़ान के लिए मजबूरी है लिए लेकिन काफ़ी ज़्यादा महंगाई है तो अभी ये मैंने लिए और वो बीमारी की वजह से तो कोरोना वायरस की वजह से भी ये मार्केट सारे इंसान सुनसान पड़े हैं.
A shopkeeper selling prayer mats and religious goods said he's seeing only about a third of the customers he would compared to a typical year.
काम का जो लेवल है वो पहले की तरह नहीं है. यानी समझे आपके 100% में से 30% पर काम आ गया. यानी पहले जो गाहक आपके पास 100 गाहक आते थे उसमें से 30 गाहक आपके पास आएंगे. और पहले जो हमें यानी मुनाफा और बचत काम में होती थी तो अभी समझे कि आप 3000 की जगह में 1000 तक आ गए.
अथॉरिटीज हैव इशूड गाइडलाइंस टू कर्ब द स्प्रेड ऑफ द वायरस ड्यूरिंग रमदान इंक्लूडिंग द वेयरिंग ऑफ फेस मास्क एंड सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग इन मॉस्क्स. And also that people with flu symptoms and those over 50 should not go to mosques at all. Ramadan, which depends on the sighting of the moon, is expected to begin in Pakistan from April 14.
In news from Afghanistan, the Afghan Interior Ministry has released the confessions of at least 9 people who were allegedly involved in a series of targeted assassinations in Afghanistan. Based on the confessions, religious leader of a mosque, a teacher of a religious seminary and a number of its students are among the suspects who have confessed to have played a role in several explosions and assassination of several military personnel and civilians. The Interior Ministry said the suspects were nabbed in Afghan capital Kabul, Logar and Laghman provinces. According to a recent report by the United Nations Assistance Mission in Afghanistan, at least 11 human rights defenders and media workers were killed in targeted attacks in the country from September 2020 to January 31, 2021. The watchdog said such attacks increase concerns about preserving freedom of expression and the media in any peace settlement. Moving on to news from Nepal. Air pollution in Nepal continued to hit hazardous levels on Friday as the country battles some of its worst forest fires in recent years. Wildfires were burning in at least 60 places across 22 of Nepal's 77 administrative districts, adding to the growing levels of pollution across the Himalayan nation. Nepal ordered schools to close for 4 days at the end of March due to air pollution, forcing millions of students to stay home. So far, 5 people have died trying to put out the forest fires that have been raging since January. Forest fires often erupt in Nepal during the January to May dry season when villagers burn dry leaves in the woodlands to prompt fresh grass growth for their cattle.
विगत 10-12 दिनदेखि नेपालको काठमाडौँ लगायत विभिन्न भागमा यो एकदमै अन्तर्राष्ट्रिय जगतमा सबैभन्दा एक नम्बरमा नै काठमाडौँ पर्ने गरी यो प्रदूषण चाहिँ नि वायु प्रदूषण देखिएको अवस्था छ यसले साधारण ठुलो असर गरेको छ.
Former Mrs. World Carolyn Jury was released on bail on Thursday after being arrested earlier in the day over the Mrs. Sri Lanka crown scuffle. The winner of the Mrs. Sri Lanka pageant, Pushpika De Silva, filed a complaint against Jury, who forcibly removed De Silva's crown, saying she was a divorcee and not qualified to win the title.
The reigning Mrs. World Carolyn Jury was released on bail on Thursday after being arrested earlier that day over an incident at the Mrs. Sri Lanka pageant on April 4, a police spokesman said. The winner of the Mrs. Sri Lanka pageant, Pushpika De Silva, filed a complaint against Jury, who forcibly removed De Silva's crown, saying she was a divorcee and was not qualified to win the title, local media reported. Jury was arrested when she came to the police station to record her statement, and another model involved in the chaos was also taken in. The winner of the Mrs. Sri Lanka contest goes on to compete in the Mrs. World contest, the first beauty pageant for married women. De Silva clarified in a Facebook post on April 5 that she was separated from her husband, not divorced. The prize was returned to her on Tuesday at a news conference after pageant organizers confirmed she was not a divorcee and apologized to her.
Thado community, the second largest community in India's Manipur state, celebrated its annual cultural festival in Imphal this week. The festival celebrates the germination and sprouting of seeds sown in the fields that bring forth new lease of life and hope. Have a look.
Second largest community Thado in India's Manipur state celebrated Hoon Thado Cultural Festival 2021 in capital Imphal earlier this week. The festival celebrates the germination and sprouting of seeds sown in the fields that bring forth new lease of life and hope. The festival cheered with performances by cultural dances and live music. The beauty and brain competition among the Thado youth through Mr. and Mrs. Thado contest was the main attractions of the fest.
But this festival also gives us the opportunity to examine our past and also the plan for the future. So I would love to celebrate this festival with a lot of joy, enjoyment with family and friends.
According to the Thado community of Manipur, Hun etymologically signifies time and season. The time here significantly encompasses something of the entire cosmology from earth to heaven, dead to life, and all the affairs of men and his spirituality. Hun, celebrated for 7 days, is more than a cultural festival. It is a civilizing act of the Thados.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. 7 terrorists neutralized in separate encounters in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Pakistanis gear up for Ramadan amid rising inflation and COVID-19 infections. And Afghan Interior Ministry releases confessions of 9 suspects in targeted attacks. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter at SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.